A team of researchers has made history by placing tiny synthetic motors inside live human cells for the first time, and then propelling them with ultrasonic waves and steering them magnetically. The medicinal possibilities for this stretch the imagination. Penn State's Tom Maluk led the research and said, "We might be able to use nanomotors to treat cancer and other diseases by mechanically manipulating cells from the inside. Nanomotors could perform intracellular surgery and deliver drugs non-invasively to living tissues." One innovation in the fight against cancer is this wearable display that helps surgeons see cancer cells while they're operating. The cells glow blue when viewed through this near-infrared fluorescence goggle system. The glasses could reduce the need for additional operations by making it easier for surgeons to remove every last tumor cell the first time a patient goes under the knife. This is definitely a technology the US will be sharing with the rest of the world. That type of cross-continental information flow that's going to ramp up in the near future will depend heavily on transoceanic cables. This is a map of all those cables, which you can sort by country and even by a specific cable to get a lot more information. And this is what they actually look like. One ocean where it'll be a lot easier to lay cable is the Arctic, according to this animation of the last 25 years of ice depletion. Notice the amount of old ice that has melted away. As Arctic sea ice melts, it exposes more open water, causing the ocean to absorb more energy from the sun. A new study from the Scripps Institute of Oceanography found that the amount of sunlight reflected off the oceans back into space has dropped by 4% since 1979. And here's a tool to visualize the effects of this ice melt, showing the various warming trends all over the planet. You can search by city or country, or simply drag and drop the pin wherever you want. As climate change inevitably creates international conflict, some countries will turn to military might to make sure things go their way. This is the US Navy's latest offering, a laser weapons system that it will begin testing this summer aboard the USS Ponce. It runs on electricity, so it'll be a much cheaper alternative to traditional ballistics. But, unlike Star Wars, the laser beam is invisible to the human eye. It doesn't produce quite the same levels of heat, but the world's largest solar thermal plant unveiled this week in the Mojave Desert outside of Las Vegas will produce enough electricity to power 140,000 homes each year. It uses 173,000 computer-controlled mirrors that follow the sun and reflect its light towards three solar receiving water boiler towers. This news couldn't come soon enough for the United States as it tries to keep pace with China, which installed a record 12 gigawatts of solar panels in 2013. Well, that'll do it for this episode of The Daily Conversation, a rundown of the science and technology stories that had us talking today. You can find all of them linked below. Make sure to like this video to help the conversation grow, and join our page on your social media network of choice. Thanks for watching. For TDC, I'm Bryce Plank.